this night and call me, Dora. I'd like to welcome everyone to the April meeting of the Cumming City Council. First of all, a little house cleaning. Chief Tatum, if you would, remove the camera from the auditorium. We don't allow filming inside of the city hall here unless there's specific reasons. So if you would, remove the camera. That's the reason we don't have Comcast up here on the wall. We don't allow that in.
Respectfully, Mayor, Georgia...
It's not a discussion. Could I have a camera removed, please?
No, sir. Georgia law, I'm exercising my right as a citizen to record this meeting.
Sir, this is an open and public meeting.
I have a right by Georgia law to film this meeting. Ask Dana Miles. Ask your counsel. Ask Dana Miles.
You're certainly able to record it and take notes and report it.
I have a right by Georgia law. There will be a complaint filed with Georgia Attorney General not allowing me to film this meeting. Take your hands off of me.
Don't file your complaint.
Take your hands off of me, sir. Let me get my answer. You are violating Georgia state law.
You're certainly able to record it or you can take notes.
This is illegal. You cannot close a meeting. I have a right by Georgia law and you should consult your counsel, Dana Miles. He is aware of Georgia state law.
Thank you very much. I'm ready to start the meeting. Again, thank everyone for being here this morning or this afternoon. If I could, I'd like to ask everyone to stand, please, and take the flag, please. I plan to lead you to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic which we stand, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you very much. First item on the agenda is consideration and adoption of the minutes of the last council meeting of March 20th and executive session meeting on the same day. I assume everybody got a copy of those minutes. If so, I hear a motion to be approved. No correction. Second. Any discussion? Signify by raising your hand, please. All unanimous. Okay, proclamations, resolutions, and recognition. First item A under item 2 on the agenda is Pro Officer Daniel Hester's for completion of his field training. We have Chief Tatum here to recommend Daniel Hester. Daniel Hester, I believe he has a plural. His name is H-E-S-T-E-R-S. Okay, and I understand he has completed 160 hours of field training program and approved by the City of Cumming. Therefore, recognizable for the certificate of City Police Officer.
Yes.
All right, will you come up, Officer Hester, Chief, present you with the proclamation here, certificate of 160 hours of appreciation, and certainly we appreciate our police officers and what they do and risk their lives and their family every day. And you and all the officers that we commend and serve, we appreciate you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, item B. Garden Week proclamation. This is a good one. I always enjoy the garden club and what they do for our community. I can remember back as a kid, Ms. Lucille Hall. She was the garden club president of the City of Cumming Garden Club. The late Lucille Hall, which was Mr. R. Hall's wife, and of course, she did a great job in beautifying back in those days, and that's been a long time ago. To recognize this Garden Week in Cumming, Georgia, whereas one of Georgia's greatest resources is its beautiful landscape and gardens, and whereas Georgia economically benefits each time tourists visit their botanical gardens state, and federal historic garden. Garden Week provides an opportunity to celebrate and recognize the importance of these areas of our state. And whereas organizations like the Garden Club of Georgia Incorporated serve the citizens of Georgia through programs that are meant to beautify our state, conserve our resources, and educate Georgians. And whereas partnering with the Georgia Department of Natural Resources Historic Preservation Division, the Georgia Department of Economic Development, and the National Park Service Southeastern Region, the Garden Club of Georgia helps to award grants for restoration of Georgia's historic gardens. And whereas on a local level, the Cumming Garden Club of the Laurel District is affiliated with the National Garden Club, the Deep South Garden Club, the State of Georgia Garden Club. And whereas the Cumming Garden Club, chartered in 1949, under the mission of beautification, conservation, and education, plays a significant role in protecting and enhancing Georgia's garden resources. Now, as Mayor of the City of Cumming, the City Council do hereby proclaim April 15th through the 21st, 2012, as Garden Week in Cumming, Georgia, and encourage citizens of our community to recognize the work gardeners and landscapers do to the City of Cumming and the State of Georgia Beautification, signed this day by myself as Mayor, April 17, 2012. Will the Garden Club people come up for acceptance of the proclamation and for a picture, please? Item C, ALS Awareness Day Proclamation. Whereas lateral thrombosis, or ALS, is better known as Lou Gehrig's disease, and whereas ALS is a fatal neurodegenerative disease characterized by degeneration of cell bodies of the lower motor neurons in the gray matter of the internal horns of the spinal cord. And whereas the initial symptom of ALS is weakness of the skeleton muscles, especially those of the extremity. And whereas, as ALS progresses, the patient experiences difficulty in swallowing, talking, and breathing. And whereas ALS eventually causes muscles to atrophy, and the patient becomes functional quadriplegic. And whereas ALS does not affect the patient's mental capacity, so that the patient remains alert and aware of his or her loss of motor functions and the inevitable outcome of continued deterioration and death. And whereas, on an average, patients diagnosed with ALS only survive 2 to 5 years from the time of diagnosis. And whereas ALS has no known cause, means of prevention, or cure. And whereas research indicates that military veterans are a 50% or greater risk of developing ALS than those who have not served in the military. And whereas the Department of Veteran Affairs implemented regulations to establish a presumption of service connection for ALS, thereby presuming that the development of ALS was incurred or aggravated by a veteran's service in the military. And whereas, the National ALS Patient Registry, administered by the Centers for Disease Control, is currently identifying cases of ALS in the United States and many, and may become the single largest ALS research project ever created. Whereas, amyotrophic lateral sclerosis awareness month increases the public awareness of ALS patients, circumstances, and acknowledges the terrible impact this disease has not only on the patient, but on her families, or his families, and the community, and recognizes the research being done to eradicate this horrible disease. Now, therefore, let it be proclaimed that May the 5th, 2012, be set aside as ALS Lateral Sclerosis Awareness Day in Cumming, Georgia, and be it further proclaimed that the City of Cumming encourages the President and Congress of the United States to enact legislation to provide additional funding for research in order to find a treatment and eventually a cure for this disease. I hereunto set my hand and cause the seal of the City of Cumming to be affixed the 17th day of April 2012, signed by the Mayor of the City of Cumming. Local people, come on up. Thank you all for bringing this to your attention. I appreciate your job. Don't try to balance out. Recognition of Jay Hendrix, volunteer public service for beekeeping. Jay, is Jay here? Certainly glad to have Jay with us tonight. Jay is an expert in beekeeping. There's been a lot of discussion about the bees recently with the Forsyth County Planning and Zoning, also with Board of Commissioners, and most of the time the facts haven't been presented. We're certainly glad to have Jay here to explain beekeeping, and certainly the City of Cumming is not about to have an ordinance against bees. I don't think that we can say that this bee is coming from your property over there, so get your bee back over there, shoot it back over there. I don't think things work that way with insects. So, Jay, glad to have you with us.
Good to be here. I didn't know I was supposed to make the presentation. And the only thing I see, we have a great local beekeepers club here that does a lot for the public. And some of them have been here a long time working on beekeeping. Bees need our help, and we need the bees. So they're in danger. I have a little obsession with bees. I got into this simply because of what I just said when I retired, so I'm a hobby beekeeper. And I do this to help the public and to help bees. So that's really the only message I would bring. I was prepared to make a presentation. I'm not sure that
we want you to have opportunity anyway, so certainly glad to have you here. And I understand that you have made yourself available if anybody needs any information in reference to the beekeeping.
That's right. one member of it, but we do want to help. And thank you for the opportunity there to come and make a comment.
Thank you, Jay. Get in touch with you. How would anybody get in touch with you if they want to discuss it?
If you go through the city administrator's office, they have all the information there. You can call me direct. I don't think
the best thing would be to go through the city and get the brochure or whatever.
That's exactly right. Either I'll come or we'll get some people to come, group of us to come. Anything that you need to do with bees or any questions you have, we'll be glad to help.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for being with us. Which enhance our quality of life. Whereas the citizens of Cumming know the vital role that water safety education plays in preventing drowning and recreational water and related injuries, it is important to abide by the rules set forth by the guardianship of trained and certified aquatic professionals who develop water safety rules with people's proven enjoyment and in mind. And whereas the citizens of Cumming recognize the ongoing efforts and commitments to educate the public on pool and spa safety issues and initiatives by the pools and spa and water park and recreation park entrants. Citizens understand the vital importance of communicating water safety rules and programs to families and individuals of all ages, whether they are owners of private pools, users of public facilities, or visitors to water parks. And whereas the recreational water industry has organized National Water Safety Month Coalition to promote safe swimming facilities, aquatic programs, home pools, spas, and related activities. Now, therefore, as Mayor of the City of Cumming, the City Council hereby proclaim May 2012 Water Safety Month in Cumming, Georgia, for South County, the 17th day of April, signed by myself as Mayor of the City of Cumming. We have someone here to receive this proclamation.
Page 3, it's the that's our independent auditor report. just not prepared to study. If you were prepared to study, you would see that the expenditure on the deputy part were either flat or even actually down. So you got to get it up. If you flip to page 18, that's the statement of revenue expenditure for water sewer fund. Revenues this year were about $14.5 million. Expenditure were about $14.4 million. Operating about $73,000. If you flip back to that, I don't think we've got over this deal. Page 39 is the schedule. Squash schedule. Account for our city's expenditure.
Item C, Aquatic Center Brochure B.
Thank you.
business local.
Okay, recommendation by the Park and Rec Board is grant the age of the brochures for the Aquatic Center, $4,426.45.
I make a motion to accept that.
I hear a motion from Willis, do I have a second?
Second.
John Lee, any discussion? Please signify by raising your hand. Unanimous, thank you very much. Thank you, Father. Item D, Police Department Siren and Radio Frequent Proposal, Chief Tatum.
This request is for the purpose of installation of radio equipment to narrowband our current radio system. The FCC has mandated that all VHF radio frequency be narrowband. They currently operate on the 25 kilohertz frequency. They're going to narrow down that to 12.5. The equipment that we have is not narrowbandable. Part of purchasing new equipment. The siren on the water tower, one of the warning siren, also has to have some things given in order to use a radio signal to activate that siren. Therefore, once this new air may come in and purchase the equipment, we won't be able to activate the siren without purchasing some equipment. It's mandated very similar to the TV play with the vehicle. The fact that you can get a signal for a VHF depending on the TV, you have that kind of box. But emergency, this is very similar in that, but they don't make that type of device. You have to purchase a radio.
This is a question, Gene. That's a heavy question here. This is a federally mandated, unfunded request. My understanding that the existing radios will cease to operate December of this year?
Yes, last day of the year.
So you're requesting, and this was a budget, so this will have to come out of the reserve contingency fund. So it's $9,269.60.
Correct.
That's cheapest of the three bills.
Yes, it's under our state contract pricing.
Okay. It's mandated, so we have no alternative except to approve the radios. Let's pledge the board.
I make a motion.
I have a motion by Lewis. I have a second.
Second.
Quincy, any discussion? Please vote. See if I raise the right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much, Judy. City Hall HVAC testing balance. We got anybody here to explain that? The student had basically told us that this is part of the program that will have to be done after the equipment is put in on heat and air conditioning.
That's correct. So what it does is it's a balance of the airflow from the top of the roof through the units and all the different sides of the ducts and everything to control the air. That will be going through this new equipment which y'all put in last month. There's the three bids we start packing. We're at the lowest bid. The lowest bid happens to be our local person here too, which we have to follow for this whole level.
The lowest bid is Westside, Texas. Is that it? $10,500?
Yes.
We had one from Research Airflow for $16,700. And the one from Town Services Incorporated was $14,800. And the low bid is SI testing. What's the pressure for? second? Yes, second. Any discussion? Where you folks sit, if I were in the right hand, you have. Thank you very much, Steve. Okay, going back to the water contract proposal. I received a letter from the commissioners this morning about 9:30 with supposedly three proposals. They're non-binding. Extension on the existing finished water contract with a single option for an additional 5-year term. Price per 1,000 gallon of finished water is $2.25. All other terms of the existing finished water agreement to remain the same. And this does say it's pounds proposal. Okay, item 3. Raw and finished water contract. A possible 25-year extension of existing finished water agreement comprised of five-year extensions, with each 5 years subject to 180-day cancellation upon written notice by the county, and also termination may occur at the expiration of any 5-year term. The county shall be obligated to purchase 800 million gallon per year of finished water, with an additional non-mandatory purchases by the county at a rate of $2.20 per 1,000 gallon. There will be no CPI adjustment. The raw water agreement shall remain as is and subject to similar extension. This is Commissioner Levin proposing. And in reference to the payment request by the City of Cumming Water Department, invoiced earlier this year, the county proposed paid to the city $11,436,450.13 in exchange for 65% ownership interest for South County and the entirety of the intake structure, and further conditioned upon for South County receiving a 65% allocation of the existing and future permitted intake capacity up to the intake's maximum withdrawal capacity of 104 million. This is the Levin proposal. Let me come in and give a few of my thoughts in reference to this proposal, per se, for South County Board of Commissioners, which I received at 9:30. This morning, 4/17/2012. But of course, it didn't take long to look this over and decide what to do with it. main, these proposals are nothing more than their ideas and quotes and statements of various individuals. And certainly they're non-binding. And they could go out on the street, talk to any John Doe, would probably come up with some of these kind of facts. I personally met with each individual commissioner over the last couple of years, and most recently I met numerous times with several commissioners to talk about what the city wanted to do and what we could do with the county, and gave them the ideas that if they put it in a contractual form and make it a binding form and send it back to the city, that I will present it to this board council for their consideration. One by one, the commissioners decided they didn't want to do that, so that's by virtue of getting this so-called proposal today. I think the main goal of the board was to go down to the Environmental Protection Division and request permits for withdrawal to be taken away from the city of Cumming. And that's what they requested, to take away withdrawal permits from the city of Cumming. It's kind of cutting off the snows to slide yourself, because their withdrawal permit furnishes over 25 million gallons a day in that price, in that range that the county gives. So, by virtue of the county going down, some of the commissioners going down and requesting the director of the EPD to take the city's permit and give it to the county, for what reason, I don't know, but that's what they request. You know, the city of Cumming has these permits for a reason. Many, many years ago, and I've been in office going on 46 years, and we have over collectively over 230 years of experience in city government. But many years ago, the city got into the water business, and we have a trust factor with EPD. We have a need factor with EPD for the city and county. We have a track record with EPD. We have stability in our local government, and they know that. We've dealt with them. But yet, they go down and try to pry away the city's permit for withdrawal. I think, simply put, that we have, and we know, there's a lack of management leadership on the Board of Commissioners. And I'd recommend to the board that we have no more correspondence with the Board of Commissioners until they get serious and send us a contract over there that's not binding, and they sign off on it. I mean, you know, if they even took the three that they sent over here and signed it, said, if y'all agree with any of this, send it back. They didn't do that. They said, we want you to sign off on it, then we'll decide whether we like it or not. That's not what they did. So I'd recommend to the board that we, the chairman entertained a motion that we not correspond with them until they get serious and want to send us a non-binding proposal over here that we can seriously look at. So that's my take, and I'll listen to any new members who wants to talk in reference to that. I have a motion from Ralph. Have a second from John D. Any discussion? Please signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, utility department purchase. We have executive session a couple of months ago. The county had authorized the purchase of some land utility for the right of way and utility department. Mr. Brewer, the minutes, the chair, entertain a motion. A motion from John Lee, second. Lewis, any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous, thank you very much. Any other business to come forward this board? If not, announcements, we have a lot of great shows going on at the Playhouse. Georgia Senior Fathers is going on April 20th and May the 6th. Musical Merch, musician presentation by Cumming Playhouse Singers, May the 8th. Paper Street Maker, a special Mother's Day weekend, May the 11th through the 13th. Delano Vito, a country music variety show from Branson, Missouri, May the 19th. Johnny Cash Now, starring Grace Atkin, May the 20th. No other business to come to this board, chair, entertain a motion to adjourn. Second. All in favor, signify.
Executive session. Yes, sir.
I hear a motion that we adjourn, go into executive session.
Second.